Hey guys, welcome to the 14th video of the playlist, and in this video we will be practicing some sketch. So this is the sketch in front of you which we are going to draw now. Okay, so first of all let us click on file, select new and click on part. Okay, now as usual we all know that whenever we want to draw or sketch something we first have to choose a plane. So here I will choose the front plane and I will click sketch. Okay, now when you look at the sketch, the first thing that you can see is nothing but this quadrilateral with six sides. Can you see this quadrilateral with six sides? Okay, and the dimension of one side of the quadrilateral is 50, as you can see here. So first of all let us draw a quadrilateral. Okay, so or you can say a polygon, it will be a better word, with six sides. And so I will draw a polygon. Now guys, can you see that this polygon is a bit tilted, but I want it to be completely straight. In the sense, I want the polygon to be something like this. I don't want the polygon to get tilted. So I will click on escape. I will select this side and I will click on horizontal. So once the horizontal relation is added, now the polygon has become perfect. It is straight, you can say. Now let us give the dimensions to this polygon. As given in the figure, the dimension of one side of a polygon is 50. Enter, it is 50 mm. Okay, now once this is done, now guys, can you see this arc? Can you see this arc which is being drawn? It is nothing but a tangent arc. Okay, so let us draw that arc. So I will select on tangent arc. I will select this point. I will select this point. Okay. Now, once this is done, can you see guys, this arc that I have drawn, this arc is present on all three sides. Can you see this all three sides? So therefore, I will simply use the circular sketch pattern command. Okay, I will use circular sketch pattern command, and since it is present on three sides, I will click on three and hit enter. Now, can you see you are getting a polygon? Now, let us give the dimensions to this polygon. Actually this will be default, yeah, because we have drawn already a tangent arc and a tangent arc depends on its starting point. Okay, now after this, now what we will do is we will draw this or we can first draw the rectangle. Okay, can you see these rectangles? We will first draw these rectangles, and even if you observe here, the rectangles are present again on the other three sides. Okay, so first of all I will select 3-point corner rectangle. Why I have selected 3-point corner rectangle? Because I know where the two corners are going to lie. So out of the three, I know where are the other two going to lie. Okay, so I select the first corner, I select the second corner, and now I can sketch. Now let us give the smart dimensions to this. The dimension of this side according to the given figure is 15. Okay, can you see it is 15? So therefore I'm going to hit enter 15 here. Okay, enter, done. Now again this rectangle is present on the other two sides as well, so therefore I will select the linear circular sketch pattern. I will select this side and select this, done. Now can you see there we are getting four instances, but we want only three instances. So I will enter 3 and hit enter. Okay, done. Now after this is done, now guys, can you see that there is a slot that is being present, and it is nothing but a straight slot, and this slot is present on all three rectangles. So I will click on straight slot, or rather I will click on center point straight slot. Okay, why I am clicking on center point straight slot? Because I know that my center of the slot is exactly vertical to this origin. See, it is exactly vertical to the origin. So I will draw this and done. Now I know that this point and the origin must be exactly vertical. Therefore, first I am going to click on escape. I will select this point. I will click on control, press keep the long press control, and select the origin. Now you can add a relation between both these points that is vertical. Okay, so now the vertical relation is being added. So this point will always be vertical to the origin. Now after this is done, now it is time for us to give the dimensions. So the dimensions are nothing but 20, and the center of the slot is at a distance of 7.5 from the side. So first let us give 20. So smart dimensions. So this is 20, and this center is at a distance of 7.5. Yeah, it is default 7.5. Done. Now once this is done, you can see here guys, now we have to give one more dimension, that is nothing but the radius, that is nothing but 3.77. Can you see this radius? It is 3.77. okay, so I will click on smart dimension. It is already activated. Okay, this, from this point it must be 3.77. done. Now once this is done, now you can see that the slot is present on all three rectangles. So I will first click on escape so that the smart dimension gets deactivated. Now I will click on circular sketch pattern, and which are the entities that I want to make a circular pattern of? It is nothing but this slot. So this complete slot has got selected, and I want only three instances equally spaced, therefore I will enter three. Okay, done. Now after this thing is done, now what we can draw is a parabola that you can see. Can you see this parabola? See this curve, bigger curve is nothing but a part of a parabola. And how we are going to draw it? Let's see that. Okay, so for that I will first select the parabola. Now this is the center of the parabola, and the parabola is extended up to this point, and right from here, see, up to here. Okay, done. Now once this parabola is done, can you see? So this is nothing but that parabola. So let us give the dimensions to this parabola. It is nothing but 66.67. I guess it should be default. Sorry, from this point. Okay, first click on escape, select smart dimensions, click on this point, and from this point it should be 66.7. as I said, this must be default. Okay, now again, if you see guys, we have to give the measurement from this point to this point. Is it mentioned in the figure? We have to check it, and even if it is not mentioned, this has to be right. Okay, it is not mentioned in the figure, but this is going to be right because the dimension 66.7 is already set. Okay, now after this thing is done, you can see that again this parabola is present on all three other two sides as well. Okay, it is present here and it is present here also. So I need two more copies of the parabola. So I am going to click on the circular sketch pattern. I will now select this parabola, and I want only three instances equally spaced. Okay, three, and hit enter. So now can you see, you are getting three parabolas. Okay. Now after this thing is done, now we are left with only this part, only this small curve which is being present. Okay, now how I have drawn this curve, can you see they have given us a dimension as 5. So in short, what I have done is that I have did offset entities of this parabola, and then I have trimmed the outside part. I will show you all how. So first of all, what I will do is that I will click on offset entities, I will select this thing, I will select reverse, and the offset I want to be at a distance of 5 mm. Now once this is done, I will click on OK. Okay, so now guys, once you have finished drawing this curve, what we will do is that we will now use circular sketch pattern. Why circular sketch pattern? Because if you see, this inside curve is present on the other two sides as well. Can you see? It is present here and here. Okay, now for you it is, the curve is looking different, but don't worry, when we use trim entities afterwards, then the curve is going to exactly look similar. Okay, so don't worry, don't get panicked here. So I will select this, I will click on circular sketch pattern, and the instances that I want is nothing but 3, and I will hit enter. So once this is done, now I am going to make use of trim entities. Now once I make use of trim entities, I have to first look at the figure, how my figure must look like. So this is how the figure must look. The curve must be enclosed inside the tangent arc which I have drawn earlier. Inside this tangent arc only the curve should be present. Okay, so I will zoom in, I will trim this part, okay, again I will do this and trim this. Now I hope guys that you all know how I am using zoom in and zoom out. I am just scrolling the middle button upwards and downwards, nothing else. Okay, similarly I am going to do on the other two sides as well. I am going to trim this away, okay, control Z, press on trim entities, trim this part and trim this part. Okay, and the same thing on the last one also. Okay, now after this is done, we are done with the curves, we are done with the, all the curves almost you can say, and the only thing that is now left in the figure is nothing but these two triangles which you can see. Okay, now one thing while drawing the triangles you must be aware of is that, see, the measure of the triangle is 50 and the triangle is exactly horizontal, the side of the triangle is exactly horizontal. And what is the dimension of the other side? It is also 50. Okay, if it is not mentioned, then it is obvious that it is going to be 50 only. We have to assume it 50. Okay, so I will first draw a horizontal, I'll select line, I will draw a horizontal line, I will click and do this. Okay, now I will click on escape. Now okay, so guys, now I know that both the sides of the triangle are similar, are say equal, therefore I will add the dimension. We know one side dimension is 50, so I will enter 50, done, and similar thing for the other side as well. I know it is 50 and it is showing that it is dimension driven. Okay, so I was already know the dimension of this. Now if you observe guys, there is one more triangle present over here also. So instead of drawing this again, what I will do is I will make use of circular sketch pattern. So for that I will first click on escape so that the smart dimension gets deactivated. Now after doing this, I will now use circular sketch pattern. This is the entity that I want to circular sketch pattern. Now again I am here going to enter 3 instances. Why 3 instances? You can only see 2 triangles, right? But why 3 instances? Because if I enter 2 instances, then what happens is that, see, I'm getting a triangle somewhere here and that I don't want. Okay, so I will enter 3 instances and what I will do is that I will use the instances to skip command, and after doing this I will deselect this instance. So I'm getting only one more triangle at the exact position that I require. Okay, now once this is done, now can you see that the sketch is ready? Yeah, nothing is left, the sketch is ready. Now what you can do is that, can you see that there are some blue color entities? So that the reason behind this is because you have not given all the dimensions to this figure. Although we are comfortable with the dimensions, but SOLIDWORKS wants us to give more dimensions. It wants us to define the sketch more. So what you can do is that you can just give dimensions to this, and I hope that you all know how to give dimensions to all these entities that are present. Okay, and once you give these dimensions, then you will see here fully defined. Okay, so if I keep on doing this, it will be a waste of time, and I know that you are capable of doing this. Okay, you can easily do this. You just have to give the dimensions to this line, this curve, and your figure will become fully defined. Okay, so guys, I hope that you have liked this video, and if you like this video, then please don't forget to subscribe to the channel.